Today's subject is evergreen trees. The demand for evergreen trees is growing, but unfortunately there's not so many different varieties on the market. But we succeeded to select some nice ones, and we're going to show them to you today. So let's go into the nursery. We're looking at a field with Ilex aquifolium, or normal holly. It's an evergreen shrub or a tree, and especially in the United Kingdom you can see it in the landscape, because it used to be a holy tree in the Celtic times in the Middle Ages, so people would never chop it down. So sometimes you can see really old solitary ones growing. They get up 5 to 10 meters high, and also the same in spread. People use it also in Christmas pieces. The leaves are quite prickly, and the older and the more mature the tree gets, the less prickly the leaves will be. It's not a very easy tree to transplant. Sometimes if you transplant it, they use quite a lot of leaves, which is not harmful to the tree, but it takes a while before the leaves start getting back. You can also prune it quite severely in different shapes, and it can be used in hedgerows, but also as a solitary plant. Also, the berries are very nice in the wintertime. Like this, it's also a tree that can withstand salt, sea spray, so it's a quite nice, hardy, healthy tree, Ilex aquifolium. This is Quercus suber, or corky oak in English. Yeah, the name says it all. The trunk is full of cork, and the tree is evergreen in the wintertime. As long as it doesn't freeze too much, like if it gets below minus 10 for a couple of nights, the leaves will turn brown, and when the new shoots appear in April, May, then it will push off the dead brown leaves. But so far they're still green, though we had some frost the last week. It's widespread around the whole Mediterranean area, especially in Spain and Portugal. You see them quite often. It can get up to 5 to 10 meters in height, and also very wide. It likes to stand in the full sun. You can also use it in the United Kingdom if it's not in a not too cold area, especially quite close to the seaside. Here you can actually see how they took off the cork about 15 years ago. So they just with an axe, they get off a whole plate of cork, and that will be dried and divided afterwards. And the whole trunk will recover afterwards, and it will form new cork that can be harvested afterwards. Very special tree. All these trees are numbered and have their own special prizes as well. It's quite an exclusive tree, Quercus suber. We're looking at the child of Quercus suber, because this is Quercus hispanica filamensis. And Quercus hispanica originates from a hybrid between Quercus suber and Quercus seris. Then you get this as a result. The nice feature of filamensis is that it inherited the corky trunk from one of its parents, with this as a result. It's also evergreen, but it's a bit more hardy than a normal Quercus suber would be. Very nice tree that can withstand salt from the street. It's very well used in sunny places, gets up to 15 meters in height approximately. Very nice solitary specimen, or as a group, Quercus hispanica filamensis. This is Prunus laurus rhesus rotundifolia, or in English cherry laurel. It's a tree that originates from southeastern Europe, and it can get 5 to 10 meters high, and also the same in spread. It's called rotundifolia because the leaf is a bit more white on the top and a bit rounded here. And also, if you crush the leaf, then it smells like bitter almond, so it's a real cherry, so to speak. It can be used as a solitary in a garden, or usually as a hedgerow. You can create a quite dense hedge with it. It's a tree that's quite winter hardy, but if you get frost on it, for instance it's 15 degrees and the next night it's minus 5, then the leaves will turn brown. but they can recover afterwards. As I said, you can use it as a solitary, but also as a solitary multi-stem with raised stems. It makes it a bit more interesting. Prunus laurosoracis rotundifolia. This is Magnolia grandiflora galissoniere. Magnolia grandiflora is also called the southern magnolia because it originates from the southeastern part of the United States. In that area it will grow up to 30 meters in height, and also in the Mediterranean area in Europe. But here in the northern part of Europe it will stay up to 15 meters. You have to consider that you plant it in a sheltered spot because it cannot withstand a lot of frost. The underside of the leaf looks a bit rusty brown with some small hairs on it. And on this tree you can still see the fruits containing this orange-red seeds. Those fruits were big white flowers last June that smell terrific. As I said, it's called galissoniere, and that's because a lord from France discovered this tree in 1745 as a more winter hardy cultivar. There's more winter hardy cultivars on the market, but this is the most well-known one. Magnolia grandiflora galissoniere. This is Psychopsis chinensis, or Chinese fake hazel. Psychopsis comes from the same family as Parotia and Hamamelis do, and it originates from Western China. It's a so-called semi-evergreen tree. That means if the winter is not too severe, the tree will keep its leaves through the whole winter. Last night we had about minus 10, but it still has all the leaves on it. It starts with the autumn coloration approximately in October, and then the leaves change a bit in color and it stays on the trees the whole winter like this. And then in summer it's covered with nice shiny green leaves again. It's a tree that grows up to 4 to 6 meters, so that's a bit smaller than a parotia is, so in that way it's a good alternative for a parotia. And also the flowers are a bit different. It has a small yellowish flower in February. Quite unknown tree, but especially if it's pruned up like this that you see on the trunks, it gives a very nice effect, so people should use it more. Psychopsis chinensis. And now last but not least, an example of a semi-evergreen oak called Quercus ternary pseudoternary, a hybrid from Quercus robur and Quercus ilex. Doesn't get too big, about 8 to 10 meters. That was it for today. Thanks for watching and see you next time.